Krishna, today Guru Maharaj is not available to give class, so Her Grace Sridevi Mataji is going to give class today on Lord Narasimha's pastimes. Thank you so much, Mataji. You can start the class, Mataji. Thank you. Hare Krishna. Sorry, please accept my humble obeisances. All glories to Srila Prabhupada and Guru Maharaj. Sorry.
Please accept mine. All glories to Prabhupada. All glories to Gurudev. And my humble obeisances to all the assembled devotees. Hare Krishna. We will begin with the invocation prayers. Om Agyanati Mirandasya Gnananjana Shalakaya Chakshurun Miritam Yena Tasmai Shri Gurave Namaha Shri Chaitanya Manobhishtam Stapitam Yena Bhutale Swayam Rupa Kadamayam Dadati Swapadantikam. So today we have these beautiful verses from the seventh canto of the Srimad Bhagavatam, which is the beautiful narration of the pastimes of Lord Narasimhadev, his devotee Prahlad, and I have chosen verse number 24 to 28 to read, just to build up the context, and then we will focus on 25, 26. So I would like all of us to be very interactive. I would like audience participation. I would like to have volunteers to read out the different verses, translations. We are all going to engage in Krishna Katha, not just me. So, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya, Narayanam Namaskritya Naram Chaiva Narottamam Devim Sarasvatim Vyasam Tato Jayamudirayet Nashta Praeshva Bhadreshu Nityam Bhagavata Sevaya Bhagavati Uttama Shloke Bhaktir Bhavati Nashtiki. Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhara Shivasadhi Gaur Bhakta Vrinda. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Vancha Kalpatarubhyascha Kripa Sindhubhyaiva Cha Patita Nam Pavanebhyo Vaishnavebhyo Namo Namaha. I offer my most humble obeisances to my dear God family, my dear brothers and sisters, and humbly beg for your blessings that I may be able to speak something by your empowerment and mercy and the empowerment of Gurudev and the Guru Parampara and the Lord, so that we all can feel enlivened and enthused about the appearance day of Lord Narasimhadev happening on Tuesday. So we have verse number 24. Who would like to read the English translation for us? Any volunteers? If nobody speaks up, I will just say, Lavanya.
Dheeraj Prabhu raised his hand, Mataji.
Wonderful. Dheeraj Prabhu, go for it. Text number 24. Can you please read the English translation?
Then there appeared before them a transcendental sound vibration emanating from a person not visible to the material eyes. The voice was carried as the sound of a cloud. It was a very encouraging feeling or fear.
Okay, would you like to read the next one too, 25 and 26?
Vibrated as follows. Best of learned person, do not fear. I wish all good fortune. Become a devotee by hearing and chanting about me and offering the prayers. All these are certainly meant to award benefit to all living entities. I know all about the activities of Hiranyakashipu and shall surely stop them very soon. Please wait patiently until that time.
Thank you, Dheeraj Prabhu. Very nice. Thank you. All the way from India. See how we are all united by Krishna's mercy from all over the world. Now I would like to have Sudha Mataji read out 27 and 28. Please.
Hare Krishna. Dhanupranam Mataji. Sure. 27, Mataji. Sorry. Okay, thank you, Mataji. Text 27. I should read the verse also, Mataji, or just the translation?
Just the English translation for now.
Oh, okay, thank you, Mataji. So, text 27 translation. When one is envious of the demigods who represent the Supreme Personality of Godhead, of the Vedas, which give all knowledge, of the cows, Brahmanas, Vaishnavas, and religious principles, and ultimately of me, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, he and his civilization will be vanquished without delay. Yeah. So, thank you, Mataji. Should I read one more verse? Or?
Yes.
Okay. Okay, so text 28, when Hiranyakasipu teases the great devotee Prahalada, his own son, who's peaceful and sober and who has no enemy, and I shall kill the Hiranyakasipu immediately despite the benedictions of Brahma.
Thank you. So thank who you. Is speaking? Thank you. Now we are going to explain to you that the Lord is reassuring all the demigods, all the people who have come to him praying for deliverance from the harassment of Hiranyakashipu. Hiranyakashipu has acquired great power by virtue of his austerity, and unfortunately, he uses that power to tyrannize, terrorize, and cause so much disturbance to everyone. And everyone is in extreme distress and being greatly harassed by this demon. What do? They turn to the Lord because he is the only shelter. And they pray to him, please deliver us from this demon. And what does the Lord say? There appeared a transcendental sound vibration. The voice was as grave as the sound of a cloud. It was very encouraging and drove away all fear. This is the voice of the Lord. So now I will request Lavanya to click on that particular text, and we will actually read this particular verse, where the Lord is reassuring his devotees. Would anyone like to read the Sanskrit translation? Any volunteers? Lavanya, would you like to read?
Yes, Mataji. Ma bhaista vibhuta sreshtaha sarvesham bhadramastuvaha Madarshanam hi bhutanam sarva shreyopapatyate. Jnatam etasya dauratmyam daityapasyadasyayat tasya santim karishyami kalam tavat pratikshata.
Okay.
So do you want me to
read the translation? Yes.
Translation and purport by His Divine Grace Srila Prabhupada, Srila Prabhupada Ki Jai. Translation, the voice of the Lord vibrated as follows. O best of learned persons, do not fear. I wish all good fortune to you. Become my devotees by hearing and chanting about me and offering me prayers, for these are certainly meant to award benedictions to all living entities. I know all about the activities of Hiranyakashipu and shall surely stop them very soon. Please wait patiently until that time.
Thank you. And this is a very beautiful purport, which I will read. Yes. Please listen up carefully, because we can all get a lot of realizations from these purports. Sometimes people are very much eager to see God. In considering the word mad darshanam, seeing me, which is mentioned in this verse, one should note that in Bhagavad Gita, the Lord says, bhaktya mam abhijanati. In other words, the ability to understand the Supreme Personality of Godhead or to see him or talk with him depends on one's advancement in devotional service, which is called bhakti. In bhakti, there are 9 different activities. Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu Smaranam, Pada Sevanam, Archanam, Vandanam, Dasyam, Sakhyam, Atma Nivedanam. Because all these devotional activities are absolute, there is no fundamental difference between worshipping the deity in the temple, seeing him, and chanting his glories. Indeed, all of these are ways of seeing him, for everything done in devotional service is a means of direct contact with the Lord. The vibration of the Lord's voice appeared in the presence of all the devotees, and although the person vibrating the sound was unseen to them, They were meeting or seeing the Lord because they were offering prayers and because the vibration of the Lord was present. Contrary to the laws of the material world, there is no difference between seeing the Lord, offering prayers, and hearing the transcendental vibration. Pure devotees, therefore, are fully satisfied by glorifying the Lord. Such glorification is called kirtan. Performing kirtan and hearing the vibration of the sound Hare Krishna is actually seeing the Supreme Personality of Godhead directly. One must realize this position and then one will be able to understand the absolute nature of the Lord's activities. Om Agyanati Mirandasya Gnananchana Shalakaya Chakshurun Miritam Yena Tasmai Shri Guruve Namaha. So Srila Prabhupada is giving a beautiful explanation about how anything in service of the Lord is on the absolute plane and puts one directly in touch with God, Krishna. In fact, Krishna explains this beautiful verses there. Bhaktya mam abhijanati yavan yas chasmi tatvataha tato jnatva something. I forget the third line. Vishate tad anantaram. Would you pull up 1855 for us, Lavanya? Tato mam. Tato mam. Something. I forget the third line. And the last line is Vishate tad anantaram. And the meaning is one can understand me as I am, the Supreme Personality of Godhead, only by devotional service. And when one is in full consciousness of me by such devotion, one can then enter into the kingdom of God. So Krishna is giving us the formula, how to know him, how to understand him, how to serve him, and how ultimately to come back to him. Tato mam tatvato jnatva vishate tad anantara. And go below to the translation. Yes. See, when one is in full consciousness of me by such devotion, he can then enter into the kingdom of God. So this is where we want to be, because this is our original home. We have come away because of so many reasons. We have turned away from the service of the Lord and we have come here. But Krishna is giving the formula how to reach him. Let's go back to the purport, Lavanya, please. So what does Krishna say over here? There is no difference. Seeing me is the same as hearing about me, is the same as serving me, is the same as offering foodstuffs to me, is the same as glorifying me. So Krishna Katha, Krishna Kirtan, Krishna Puja, all these are on the absolute level and all of these help us to come closer and closer to the Lord. And this is his promise. This is his word. He gives his word that I will protect you. I will take care of you. Become my devotee and you will gain everything. In this particular translation, we see over here, become my devotee. There are two other very famous verses in the Bhagavad Gita where, yes, serving the devotees of the Lord. Yes, Dhiraj Prabhu. Become, Krishna is saying, become my devotee. He's giving us this instruction. Can anyone tell me which two verses in the Bhagavad Gita Krishna is saying very clearly, become my devotee? I'll give you a hint. Manmana. It begins with manmana. Anyone? Anyone want to take a chance? Let's see how much you remember of your Bhagavad Gita. How many of you have done Bhakti Shastri among the people over here? Quite a few, I'm sure.
So this is from chapter 9, Mataji.
Yes.
Manmana yes. Bhava mad bhakto mad jyaji man namaskuru.
Mam evaishasi yuparam atmanam mat parayanaha. Engage your mind in thinking about me. Become my devotee. Krishna is saying, become my devotee. And again, in verses 1865, Krishna again says the same thing. Manmana bhava mad bhakto mad jyaji man namaskuru. Mame vaishyasi satyam te prati jane priyasimi. Always think of me, become my devotee, engage in worship of me, offer obeisances to me. Thus you will come to me without fail. I promise you this because you are my very dear friend. So you see, Krishna is giving us the formula how to become closer and closer and closer and come back to who we really are, loving servitors of Krishna fully and completely. So here in this purport it says, in other words, the ability to understand the Lord, to see him or talk with him, depends on one's advancement in bhakti. And how is the Lord seen? By the ears. Shravanam, Kirtanam, Vishnu Smaranam, Padasevanam, Archanam, Vandanam, Dasyam, Sakyam, Atmanivedanam. All these nine processes of devotional service can be engaged in, and they will give the same result. And there is no difference, Krishna, Srila Prabhupada is explaining, whether we are sweeping the floor of the temple room, whether we are washing the utensils in the temple kitchen, whether we are decorating and dressing the deity, whether we are making garlands, whether we are giving class, whether we are repairing the windows, whether we are repairing the doors, whether we are doing book distribution, prasadam distribution, cooking, cleaning, everything done for Krishna is on the absolute plane and puts us in touch with Krishna. That is yoga, linking up with Krishna. So it's all on the absolute plane. There's no difference. And Krishna is explaining that how to come back to him, engaging in devotional service. So what is Krishna, what is Srila Prabhupada encouraging us to do? Kirtan. Performing kirtan, hearing the vibration of Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare, will gradually purify us more and more and more and more. And just like the iron, when it is placed in the fire, it becomes red hot and is non-different from the fire. We will come back to our original position of being pure, loving servitors of the Lord without any contamination of the material energy. And that is realizing our position. When we realize this position, then we will be fully joyful. As Krishna again says in the ninth chapter, Su Sukham Kartum Avyayam. What is that? Raj Vidya Raj Guyam Pavitram Idam Uttamam Pratyakshavagamam Dharmyam Su Sukham Kartum Avyayam. Su Sukham, joyfully perform. And this is everlasting, it is joyfully performed. This knowledge is the king of education, the most secret of all secrets. It is the purest knowledge. And because it gives one direct perception of the self by realization, it is the perfection of religion. It is everlasting and it is joyfully performed. So there's great joy in engaging in the service of the Lord, and we will become more and more and more purified of lust, anger, greed, illusion, pride, envy, all these nasty things which are sitting in the heart for many millions of lifetimes will all be washed away by the Sri Krishna Sankirtana, which cleanses the heart. Cheto Darpana Marjanam Bhava Mahadavagni Nirvapanam Shreya Kairava Chandrika Vitranam Vidyavadu Jivanam Anandam Budivardhanam Pratipadam Purnam Ritaswadhanam Sarvatma Snapanam Param Vijayate Shri Krishna Sankirtanam. So all glories to the Sankirtan movement. It ends the cycle of birth and death. It engages us in this nectar for which we are always anxious, and it stops the repetition of birth and death. So what a wonderful process we have, and how grateful we should feel to our Gurudevs, to Srila Prabhupada, to the Guru Parampara, for giving us this pure knowledge which will take us all the way to the perfection of religion. And this is why Krishna comes. Why does he come to this earth planet? He says in Bhagavad Gita, very famous verses, verse 4, 7 and 4, 8. Yada yada hi dharmasya ganer bhavati bharata abhyutanam adharmasya tadatmanam shrijamyaham. Whenever and wherever there's a rise of irreligious practices, and whenever and wherever there's a decline in religious practices and a predominant rise of irreligion, I descend myself. Why? To correct that, to cause the devotees to become happy, which is there in the next verse, to deliver the pious, to annihilate the miscreants, and to re-establish the principles of religion, I myself come down millennium after millennium. Paritranaya sadhuna विनाशाय च दुष्कृतां धर्म संस्थापनार्थाय संभवामि युगे युगे. So here, Lord Narsingdev is reassuring. Don't worry. I know all about the activities of this demon Hiranyakashipu. I will surely stop them very soon. Please wait patiently until that time. And in the next verse, what does the Lord say when anyone goes again? Can we just scroll down, Lavanya, please? For the translations, we'll just look at those beautiful translations. What is the Lord saying here? When one is envious of the demigods, of the Vedas, of the cows, of the Brahmanas, of the Vaishnavas, of religious principles, and ultimately of me, he and his civilization will be vanquished without delay. And the devotees will emerge triumphant and victorious. Right? Why? Because Krishna is there protecting them. Kanteya pratijanihi, pratijanihi, name bhakta pranashati. Oh, son of Kunti, declare it boldly. My devotee will never be vanquished. So this is Krishna's promise in the Gita. So we can feel very reassured that we have Krishna's protection. Lord Narsingdev is there. Our Guru Parampara is there protecting us. I cannot count the number of times Guru Maharaj has said in the class again and again, devotees don't have to worry. Devotees don't have to worry. Devotees don't have to worry. Krishna is there protecting the devotees. Haven't we heard that practically every class throughout this COVID time? The whole world has been in such disarray and confusion and turbulence and fear. But we are sitting nicely under the shade of Guru Maharaj's lotus feet, like all the gopas and gopis under Krishna's protection of the golden hill. And we are safe and secure at his lotus feet, isn't it? We don't have to worry. We don't have to fear. We don't have to get into confusion or, you know, any kind of disturbance because we have taken shelter. Guru Charan Namvija Nirbhara Bhakta. There's a beautiful song, Bhaja Govindam, Bhaja Govindam, Bhaja Govindam Mudhavate. But that there's one particular verse. It says, Guru Charanambuja Nirbhara Bhakta Samsara Rachirat Bhava Mukta. So one who has taken shelter of Guru Charan, he is completely at peace. He has nothing to worry. The Lord will arrange for the devotee to simply cross over the ocean of material existence without any fear. We are simply safely in the boat of Srila Prabhupada's ISKCON and we will cross over the ocean of material existence simply chanting, dancing, taking prasadam and joyfully helping one another. Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Ram, 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 Hare Hare. So this is what I would like to say. And we can now open up for questions, comments, realizations, corrections, sharing. So we can
Hare Krishna, Mataji, Dandat Pranam.
Hare Krishna, is that Swapna?
Yes, yes, Mataji.
Jai, all the way from Pune, India.
Yes, yes. Mataji, yeah. I have got a question. See, due to Corona, there is no maid at home. And in India, maids are very common. So lot of work. And that's why what's happening, that I'm not able to maintain my consciousness. See, what happens after cleaning the utensils, dishes, I have to cook. And again, dishes and again to cook and again the dishes, the cycle goes on the day because kids are at home, they need something and they are used to cook food. So even if they eat snacks and all, they are not that satisfied. So I am not able to maintain my consciousness, which I used to earlier. Always there is something in the mind that after this, I have to do this, after this, I have to do this. So I'm really worried about my consciousness. Morning I chant, get up and chant, and then I start my work. And morning I pray to Radharani ki whatever I'm doing it for you. And beech mein jab yaad aata hai, oh sorry, not Hindi. Whenever I remember in daytime, I pray. When I'm cooking, I pray. Before going to sleep, I pray and offer gratitude that she put give me service. but while doing it was very easy initially, but that's not, I'm not able to sustain the consciousness. I'm really worried about that.
Yes, this is a very big challenge for us in Kali Yuga, because as Krishna says, Arjuna says, you know, controlling the mind, it's easier to control the wind than to control the mind, because it's all over the place and it takes us here, there, everywhere. Yeah, it is very challenging. We are going through very, very difficult times. You are doing your best. I can see that. You're praying to Radharani. You're praying for her mercy. Slowly, slowly, with time, things will actually improve, because your kids are small now. As they grow up, they will be able to share. They will be able to help in the housework. It's not like the same situation will remain forever. So you can take courage from that, and you can take solace and comfort from that, that Krishna is watching. He knows our struggles, and he's very kind to his devotees. So you do your best, and Krishna will do the rest. You try your best and let Krishna do the best, do the rest, because how much we can do. So you can, you know, try to see how to keep your own consciousness at a good level by early morning rounds, by engaging in prayer, by constantly calling out to Krishna to help you through the various chores of the day. Maybe you can ask help from your children. The elder one can help out a little bit. And you can say, mommy needs to do also other things. Can you all join in so that the work gets divided? So like that, start training the children to take some responsibility. I have noticed that even myself growing up, you know, I was spoiled like anything. My mother would say, yeah, you have to do housework anyway when you grow up and go to your home. Don't do anything. Just focus on studies. I'll do everything in the kitchen and finish. That was it. We would sit around lazily, not doing anything, and poor mother would be slaving away. That's not a good idea. We have to engage all the members of the household to share in the housework so that they learn responsibility, and that is devotional service. They're engaging in service of the Lord. Every time they help you in the kitchen in cooking, they're also engaging in devotional service. So try to see how you can engage all of them so that they can also join in, and the burden is not completely on you. That is just my humble suggestion. But we can ask the Radha Matajis also on this call. Maybe someone else can also share. How can we help our sister in Pune, Dr. Swapna? Anybody has suggestions for her?
You said very nicely, Mataji. So that's all I can also say, like chanting and reading and having be in the Guru Maharaj's shelter. And that's how we can be always Krishna consciousness, I think.
Right. And it's a process, you know, little by little, you will find that you are more and more at peace. Look at yourself 1 year ago. Things were very different. And now things are very different. So little by little, we will be able to overcome so many things. The main thing is to just keep on keeping on, not give up. Never feel discouraged, never give up. And Krishna will help.
Thank you so much, Mataji. I'm really relieved, because I was really worried about this for many weeks. Thank you.
Don't worry. Krishna will take care. Don't worry.
Thank you.
Thank you for sharing your heart so openly and trustingly. We are so grateful by the gift of trust. Thank you. Anybody else would like to say anything or ask questions or make some comments or corrections?
Do you want me to put the screen up on Mataji?
No, now we can request everyone to put on their cameras. Let's all see each other. We are one God family. Don't feel shy. Prabhupada has brought us all together. Isn't it? We are happy people, all united in ISKCON. We are happy people, all united in ISKCON. We belong to one family. Prabhupada wants us all to live in unity, in spite of every caste and creed. From the north and from the south and from the east and west, he has brought us all together. Yes, we are delighted that we are united into one big family. Yes, we are delighted that we are united into one big family. Yay! I'm giving a big hug to my God brothers and God sisters.
Hare Krishna, very nice.
Yeah, this is to encourage all of us. We are all one family. It's our trials and tribulations are everyone's trials and tribulations. Our joys and happiness is everyone's joy and happiness. We are one family. We share each other's anxieties, worries, difficulties, challenges, and then it becomes lighter. If I have to carry the burden alone, it's so hard. But if I share it with my God family, what happens? It becomes lighter, isn't it?
Well, Mataji, yes.
Yes, Mataji.
Yeah, so that's what we are here for. We are here to hold hands and help each other cross over this forest fire of material life. Such a difficult thing. That's why we have this ISKCON, this association of devotees. We are all here to help one another, to love one another, to care for one another, to share in each other's trials and tribulations, and to share in each other's joys and happiness too. Yes?
Yes, Mataji, anyone wants to share any realizations?
Yes, please share your realizations of Lord Narasimhadev or Srila Prabhupada or your Gurudev. Anything is most welcome. Please do share. Yes, Sudha Mataji, please go ahead. My humble obeisances to you.
Oh, Hare Krishna. Dandat Pranam Mataji. My humble obeisances to you. I don't have any questions, Mataji, but it's a very beautiful session. I mean, nice verses you have shared. By listening to these verses and reading these verses, it actually increases our faith a lot. Yeah, it's very beautiful, Mataji. So I just wanted to share this like text 22 to 23, which you have so nicely explained. Like this Hiranyakasipu, like you see, like the Hiranyakasipu's influences everywhere. Mm-hmm. Even in the Kaliyuga also, we see like, you know, Hiranyakasipu's that kind of mentality is like in, sometimes I feel like it's also in me everywhere. So only Supreme Personality of Godhead, like if you take shelter of the Supreme Personality of Godhead, you can actually can cross over that. So I like this purport. It's very nice. It says like during Hiranyakasipu's time, his influence was everywhere, but he could not force his influence into the places where Supreme Personality of Godhead had his pastimes. Example, on this earth, there are such places as Vrindavana, Ayodhya, which are called Dhamas. In Dhamma, there is no influence from Kaliyuga or any demon. If one takes shelter of such a Dhamma, worship of Lord becomes very easy and resultant spiritual advancement quickly takes place. Thank you, Mataji. I mean, it really, so many striking points today, just four verses. Thank you for explaining beautifully. Thank you, Mataji. I just want to share this.
Yes, thank you very much for pointing out. Those are very beautiful verses and you have said something very significant because those are the places of the Lord, the Dham, Mayapur, Jagannath Puri, Vrindavan, Ayodhya, all these are the places of the Lord's pastimes. Kali Yuga has no influence. And when we go there, we can make a lot of advancement. In fact, Srila Prabhupada says everyone should go once a year for God Purnima to Mayapur. Why? To purify, to recharge ourselves. And then we can again come back and carry on with our other activities, preaching and so on. But going once to the Holy Dham, at least once a year, is very important for our spiritual life. So thank you for bringing that out more. Very nicely brought out. Thank you. Anything else?
So Mataji, I was looking into this purport. So on the 26th verse, the vibration of the Lord's voice appeared in the presence of all the devotees, and although the person vibrating the sound was unseen to them, they were meeting or seeing the Lord because they were offering prayers and because the vibration of the Lord was present.
Mm-hmm.
So can you a little bit explain on this, Mataji? I couldn't understand.
Yeah, because the voice of the Lord was there, the Lord was present there. It isn't that we have to actually see the Lord and then only he's present. We can hear the sound vibration, and hearing the voice of the Lord is as good as meeting the Lord face to face, because it's the voice of the Lord and everything of the Lord is on the absolute level. So they were meeting the Lord, even though they couldn't see him with their eyes, simply by hearing the voice of the Lord, they were with the Lord. They were associating with the Lord because he was present in the form of sound vibration. Mm-hmm. Just as we say, Krishna is non-different from his name because Krishna is absolute. When we say Hare Krishna, Krishna is there because the name is non-different from Krishna. And so when we are associating, that's why it's so important for us to really hear when we are chanting the sound vibration, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, 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 Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, 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 Hare Hare. We must understand that Krishna is there. He is there in the sound vibration. And if I pay close attention, with full attention, if I chant, I can connect with Krishna. We must have this conviction. And then when we chant like that, we will slowly start realizing the presence of Krishna. Because the sound is non-different from him.
Yeah.
In fact, Krishna's holy name is even more merciful than Krishna, because we can chant anywhere, at any time, in any way. We can chant in a sing-song way, we can chant like we chant japa, we can chant together, we can chant alone, we can chant. There are no hard and fast rules for chanting these names, my Lord. Second verse of Shikshashtakam. Nam nam akari bahudha nijasarva shaktis tatra pita niyamita smarane na kalaha eta drishi tava kripa bhagavan mamapi durdevam idrisham iha jani nanuragaha. Oh my Lord, your holy name alone can render all benedictions to living beings. And thus, you have hundreds and millions of transcendental names, such as Krishna and Govinda, in which you have invested all your transcendental energies. There are no hard and fast rules for chanting these names, my Lord. Out of kindness, you enable us to easily approach you by your holy names. But I am so unfortunate. I have no attraction for them. So you see, Krishna has invested himself completely in his name. So when you hear his voice, that's Krishna. Mm. So therefore, they were directly in the presence of the Lord. As good as seeing the Lord.
Yes, Mataji. Yeah. So we have to, we know that the holy name is non-different from Krishna. So that's why, so wherever we hear the Lord's name and Lord's glorification, then we can see that Lord is there.
Mm-hmm.
Lord is present there.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. That is why we are encouraged to do kirtan. Come together and congregationally chant the holy names of the Lord. This is the Yuga Dharma. Mm-hmm. This is what Lord Chaitanya wants. He wants that everywhere the holy name is sung, in every town and village. Prithvi te ache yata nagaradi gram, sarvata prachar, hoi ve mora naam. In every town and village, my holy name will be sung. So this is what Krishna wants. This is his instruction also. And we must all come together congregationally chanting the names of the Lord. It's non-different from the Lord, and we will feel the presence of the Lord more and more and more as we engage in this process. Like I said in the beginning, it's like an iron in the fire. In the beginning, a iron rod is, you know, cold, like anything. We are like that. But as we are put into that fire of purification more and more and more, we become red hot like the fire. We become fired up You want to be fired up, isn't it? Yes. There's no retirement in Krishna consciousness. There's only refirement. You get more and more fired up. Right? There's no retirement. We don't grow old in Krishna consciousness. You grow younger and younger. Yeah, yeah, why? Okay. Because we're getting our spiritual bodies back. We're getting our spiritual consciousness back. We're getting back who we really are. Eternal, loving servants of Krishna. Even Jesus says, become like small children. Then you can enter the kingdom of God. So we all want to become small kids now. We don't want to grow old. I'm joking a little bit. There's no doubt the body is going to grow old and die and perish. But yes, our soul, it never grows old. It never dies.
But our enthusiasm should not die.
Yes, very important. Very, very important. Rupa Goswami says that utsaha, dhairya, nischa. So enthusiasm, and we must also have determination, and we also must have patience. All these things must be in place, and of course we must avoid all that is unfavorable, and we must accept all that is favorable to our devotional service, always remaining under the shelter of our spiritual master, taking his instruction as our life and soul. We live to follow and carry out the order of Guru. We are simply order carriers. If my Guru Maharaj just says jump, I'm going to ask how high? Because what is the spiritual master giving us those instructions? It's only for my welfare. The spiritual master has no other interest other than the genuine welfare of his disciple. In fact, there is no well-wisher in the material world, truly speaking, other than the spiritual master. So we want to follow the words, make the words emanating from his lotus mouth one with your heart, and do not desire anything else. Guru Mukha Padma Vakya Chitte Te Koriya Aikya Arana Koriyo Mani Asha. Do not desire anything else. Attachment to his lotus feet is the best means of making spiritual advancement. Shri Guru Charane Rati Ese Uttama Gati Ye Prasades Pure Sarva Asha. So we want to make our life successful. We want to make our life perfect. Why not? Why not? Why shouldn't we? We have got human form of life. After going through 8,400,000 species, finally this fool has come to human form of life. After being in the body of an ant and a grasshopper and a slug and a caterpillar and a snake and a scorpion, finally I have come to human form of life. Why should I not make this life successful? You tell me. We should try our level best to make this life successful, because in the human form of life, we have the loophole to end the cycle of repeated birth and death. So we must take every chance to make our life successful and go back home, back to God and back to Krishna, never to come back to this material world of repeated birth and death. We don't want that. Why should we come? What is there to come for? Look at the world. What a state it is in. More and more Hiranyakashipu everywhere. We don't want to come back here. Unless, of course, Krishna wants us to come back, then, of course, if it's the Lord's personal desire that we come back to preach or to carry out his service in some way, that's a different birth. It is not being forced to come and take on all the problems of material world. That birth, you're protected by Krishna and you're simply engaged in Krishna's service. That's a very glorious birth, actually. So we want to make our life successful. We don't want to come back here and suffer endlessly. We have done enough of that, right? So we take shelter of Lord Narsingadev and we pray to him to destroy all the demons of fruitive desires. That beautiful verse is there, 5.18.8. Guru Maharaj just spoke on that verse. In that verse it says, oh my Lord, you possess nails and teeth just like thunderbolts. Kindly vanquish our demon-like desires for fruitive activities in this material world. Please appear in our hearts and drive away our ignorance so that by your mercy We may become fearless in the struggle for existence in this material world. So we can pray like this every day to Lord Narsingadev to protect us and to grant us fearlessness. Swapna, this is a nice prayer for you. You tend to be worrying all the time, right? So chant this prayer to Lord Narsingadev early morning, every day before you begin your day.
Yes, Mataji.
Srimad Bhagavatam 5:18:8. It's a very beautiful. Om Namo Bhagavate Narsimhaya Tejas Tejase Avir Avir Bhava Randaya Randaya. Like that it goes. I don't know the whole thing properly. I wish I could say it. But I just say the English translation every day. Yeah. 5:18:8. Very beautiful words. And I just say the English translation every day. You can say the Sanskrit and English if you want. But the Lord will grant you a worry-free existence. Yes, beautiful words. Thank you, Lavanya. Om Namo Bhagavate Narasimhaya. Namaste Jas Tejase Avir Avir Bhava. Vajra Nakha Vajra Damstra Karmashaya Randaya Randaya Tamo Grasa Grasa Om Swaha Abhayam Abhayam Atmani Bhuishta Om Kshaum. And the translation is below. I'm going to make Swapna read it. Swapna, can you read it for us?
Mataji, my specs are not near me. So I need to hunt for them.
Okay. We will ask someone else to read. Who would like to read? Someone who has not spoken today will read. Who is there online? Lakshmi. Lakshmi, would you like to read for us?
I can. Some of the words are covered though. If you could scroll it down a little bit.
Okay. Scroll it down.
Perfect, thank you. I offer my respectful obeisances unto Lord Narsingadev, the source of all power. O my Lord, who possesses nails and teeth just like thunderbolts, kindly vanquish our demon-like desires for fruitive activity in this material world. Please appear in our hearts and drive away our ignorance, so that by your mercy we may become fearless in the struggle for existence in this material world.
Jai! Lord Narsingadev Ji ki jai!
Jai!
Thank you, Lakshmi. Very nice reading. Encouraging to all of us. Thank you. Anybody else would like to share something or say something about Lord Narsingadev or Prahlad or Srila Prabhupada? Or our beloved Gurudev. We just have a few minutes more, 5 more minutes. Who is iPhone? I don't know who that is. Is that Govardhan Leela?
Hare Krishna Sri Mataji. This is Nitai Natraj.
Oh, Nitai Natraj. Our Uber hero distributing Prabhupada's books right, left, center. How are you doing with COVID and everything?
Everybody.
Are you okay?
I think it's not.
How is your health now, Prabhu? We are not able to hear.
Yes, Mataji.
I cannot hear what Prabhu is saying.
Yeah, okay, Prabhuji, your voice is cutting, Prabhuji.
I think it's cutting up, Abhi.
Yeah.
Maybe you can just write in the chat for us just to let us know how you're doing.
Can you hear me now? I think it's probably maybe the...
Yeah, we can hear you now.
No.
You're going in and out. I think sometimes your voice is coming and sometimes it's not.
Phone or something could be.
You're hearing a lot of sound from Eknath Prabhu, right?
Yeah,
Okay, so if no one has anything else to say, we can end the class. We can offer our humble obeisances to all the Vaishnavas. Thank you all.
Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Hare Krishna, Eknath Prabhu. Kasa kai? Barayat ka tumhi?
अरे माताजी मित्र चक्कीत झालं तुम्ही मराठी बोलताय
मराठी बोलते मी
तुम्ही कुठले आहे माताजी
मी ऍक्च्युअली साऊथ इंडिया मधून आले पण मुंबई मध्ये मोठी झाली म्हणून मला
मराठी अरे बोल आता तुम्ही कुठे आहात
अमेरिका
माताजी मी आता जर मराठी बोललो तर बाकीच्या लोकांना कळेल काय माझी इंग्लिश जास्त इम्प्रूव नाहीये तर तुम्ही बाकीच्यांना मारू संदेश द्या हरे कृष्णा माताजी
हरे कृष्णा सो व्हाट हू इज सेइंग दैट इफ ही कंटिन्यूस टॉकिंग मराठी नो वन विल अंडरस्टैंड सो नो प्रॉब्लम
यस यस
स्पीक इन इंग्लिश एवरीवन विल
ओके ओके मैम ओके माताजी already I am very happy to see and already I am not aware you have to talking in Marathi I am surprised Mataji very surprised already I am last two time I will meet to you online but that time I was not talking to you in Marathi. I am very surprised, Mataji. और एक बात पूछना था माताजी जानकीनाथ दास हमारे कैसे है वो मेरे 2008 में मिले थे नासिक में वो जानकीनाथ प्रभु जिनकी तबीयत खराब थी वो मुझे पूछना था आपके पास मालूम है आपसे
जानकीनाथ प्रभु इंग्लैंड यूके में है
यस 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 अमित शाह जिगर शाह जिगर जिगर
जिगर यस जानकीनाथ प्रभु डज एनीबॉडी हैव इंफॉर्मेशन अबाउट जानकीनाथ एकनाथ प्रभु वुड लाइक टू नो थैंक यू लावण्या थैंक यू वेरी मच नो आई विल एज सून एज आई गेट सम इंफॉर्मेशन एकनाथ प्रभु आई विल पास इट ऑन टू यू
Yes, yes, thank you, ma'am. Mataji, Hare Krishna, all glories to Sri Prabhupada and Dandavat to all.
Dandavat pranams to all the Vaishnav devotees of the Lord who are just like desire trees, full of compassion for others. They can fulfill the desires of everyone. So we pray to the Vaishnavas. Thank you very much. Okay, so I will say...
Really, I am so happy to you, seen Mataji, and you are a very wonderful lecture in today's.
I hope you enjoyed it. I don't know so much philosophy, I don't have so much knowledge, but somehow Krishna's mercy and Guru Maharaj's mercy, he wanted me to speak, so I spoke something. I'm not so knowledgeable, I'm not so learned, so please forgive me because Guru Maharaj is not there. I will try to improve. That's all I can say.
Thank you very much, Mataji.
Thank you. Thank you, Eknath Prabhu. Jai.
Hari Bol. Jai, Jai. Jai, Mataji.
Hare Krishna. Okay. We will see you all again tomorrow. Thank you very much.
Yes, yes, yes. Yes. Thank you very much, Mataji.
Mataji, thank you so much for the wonderful class, Mataji.
Thank you, Dheeraj Prabhu, for coming on and staying on. Really appreciate your presence. Please keep coming and enlivening us. We all have a very important duty and responsibility to the whole world. We have to become Krishna conscious and then we have to spread Krishna consciousness everywhere.
Yes, Mataji. Yes, Mataji. Mataji, Guru Maharaj is not present.
He's traveling today and so that's why he asked me to give class.
Thank you so much. Thank you, Dheeraj Prabhu.
Swapna, please remember that verse and recite that beautiful verse. I promise you, you will find a difference by chanting that verse.
Yes, Mataji, I'll do it.
Yes. Do it first.
518:8, right?
Yes.
Okay. Thank you, Mataji. Hari Bol.
Thank you, dear devotees, Nitai Nataraj Prabhu and Eknath Prabhu, Dheeraj Prabhu, Samya Datri and Lakshmi and Swapna. My humble obeisances, Lord Narsingadev Ki Jai.
Hare Krishna, take care.
Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.
Thank you very much.
Mataji. Hari Bol. Hari Bol, Mataji. Dandavad.
Dandavad Pranam. So shall I end the class now? Huh? Is that okay with everybody? Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Hello?